Good morning sa inyong lahat. Sino sa inyo ang gustong maging katulad ni Dr. Strange? For those of you na hindi nyo kilala kung sino si Dr. Strange, let me give you an explanation. Si Dr. Strange ay isa sa mga Marvel characters, you know, na siya yung parang merong kakaibang kapangyarihan, you know, through the waving of his hand or through some kind of magic. Nakaka-create siya ng mga portals or doors, open doors, no? Kung saan nakakapunta siya sa iba't ibang lugar, no? Even sa mga multiverse, ganyan. So, you know, when you think about that, no? Di ba? Medyo kakaiba talaga yung kapangyarihan na yun, di ba? Just by, you know, waving your hand, makakapunta ka na kung saan mo gusto pumunta, or you can, you know, do things na parang kakaiba, di ba? Well, today, we are going to talk about, hindi yung tuko sa magic ni Dr. Strange, but something na may kinalaman sa pinagkaloob sa atin ng Panginoon at nais niya ipagkaloob sa atin bilang mga mananampalataya. At yan ay walang iba kundi yung tinatawag na open doors. Yan po ang series natin today. Now, itong open doors, of course, is something na gusto kong maunawaan natin, no? Bakit po ba? Alright? Christians po kasi are unaware of what is available to them because of Christ. Maraming mga mananampalataya medyo ignorant doon sa idea ng open doors. Maring siguro sa kanilang buhay na iisip nila yan, pero only in relation siguro sa mga gusto nilang magawa o ma-accomplish, you know, yung tinatawag nating open doors, di ba? Pero as far as God is concerned, meron din siyang open doors na inihahanda at naisibigay sa atin po bilang mga tagasunod ni Kristo. Dahil nga hindi alam ng mga mananampalataya itong open doors na galing sa Panginoon, they miss the opportunities that God makes available for them. If they will trust in Him. So, nami-miss out nila yung opportunities na yun. No? Nice ng Panginoon na bigyan tayo ng ganung klaseng mga bukas na pintuan. Pero dahil minsan di tayo aware, we don't pray about it, we don't desire it, and of course, we don't seek it. No? They waste their time, okay? Sa kanilang resources, time and resources, no? Dabbling in worldly pursuits, o yung mga worldly false attachments, you know, worldly pursuits and false attachments, kung saan na de-destruct sila, or maybe kayo ito, sometimes ako din, di ba? So we are distracted by things of this world at mga false attachments na hindi naman talaga ito yung purpose o layunin ng Panginoon para sa atin. So maraming mga mananampalataya settle for mediocrity. Ano ibig sabihin ng mediocrity? Yung parang wala silang pinupuntahan as far as their spiritual lives are concerned. Now, siguro sa mundo may pinupuntahan sila o tayo. Siguro na umaasenso tayo sa ating mga careers. Siguro yung business natin medyo musbong naman, no? Or maybe yung love life natin medyo exciting. Pero as far as God is concerned, parang wala lang. You know, walang nangyayaring anything exciting about that. So many settle for mediocrity sa kanilang Christian lives instead of experiencing the glory of God. And this is sad kasi hindi naman ito talaga ang tinatawag nating, you know, the Christian life that God wants us to experience. You know, sabi nga ni Jesus, I have come that you may have life, life in all its fullness. So, sa totoo lang, maraming mga mananampalataya ang nakaka-miss out dito sa tinatawag na open doors, no? So, kailangan natin, what we need is a deeper understanding, no, ng concept ng open door. So, today we begin a new series at nais natin umpisahan sa tanong na ito, okay? What is an open door? So, handa nyo na ang inyong mga notebook o siguro mga online notepad. Tayo po ay mag-aaral tukol dito sa open door. Ano ba ito? What does it mean? So, i-ready na po natin ang sarili natin. If you are right now listening and nasisense mo sa heart mo, Pastor, ako yata yung tinutukoy mo. My Christian life is basically just coasting along in autopilot. Walang nangyayari anything exciting about it. If you are that person today, I exhort you to listen carefully. Or if you know somebody na ganun yung kanyang kalagayan, na parang yung Christian life niya ay lukewarm, walang nangyayari, anything that would show that God is present sa buhay niya, and maybe you need to pray for that person and also share itong sermon na ito sa kanya as soon as we are done. Or even right now, you can share it sa kanya, no, by just clicking the share button. So manalangin po tayo, and let's ask the Lord to guide us and speak to us and open up our eyes to the truth na merong open doors na nire-ready si Lord para sa atin. Amen? So samahan niyo ako. Let's all pray. Father, you are a good, good Father. And tunay nga, Lord, we don't want to miss out on anything that you want to give to us. And specifically, itong open doors, kung saan we can see the glory of God sa buhay namin. If only we would believe, if only we would trust. Lord, dinadalangin po namin ang bawat isa sa amin who may have become content na lang sa going to church every Sunday and not really expecting anything new, anything exciting. Or maybe we have friends like that, Panginoon, na parang wala na silang interest to really explore ano pa ba ang meron sa Christian life. Lord God, the open doors concept, Lord, is really an exciting thing. If only we could understand it. So Lord, open our eyes today and help us to understand itong open doors upang sa ganon we can begin to journey together as a church and individually magkaroon kami ng expectation of your open doors sa buhay namin. So Lord, tulungan mo kami right now as we begin itong series na ito. Speak to us, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Now, by the way, you know, before I even dive into this talk, no, I want you to know na next Sunday, in-announce kanina, di ba, that we are going to have a prayer gathering, no? To pray for our own open doors as a church, but also to pray for our individual open doors. So I would like to invite you sa prayer gathering next Sunday, you know, sa Real Life Center, kung saan we will come together to pray. So yeah, I will announce that again mamaya as we end. So what is an open door? Yan ang question natin dito sa unang-unang bahagi ng ating series. I want to talk about three access points kasi yung open door that comes from the Lord, ika nga, is an access, you know? It's an access point, no? Katulad din nga nung ginagawa ni parang Dr. Strange, di ba? Bagamat yun ay parang katang-isip lamang, fantasy lang yan. But here we're talking about reality. We're talking about what, you know, is truly possible in the Christian life. And God has provided for us yung ganung klaseng mga experiences called open doors in order for us to gain entry o magkaroon tayo ng access sa tatlong bagay or aspekto. So ano-ano ito? Una sa lahat, it gives us access to the presence of Christ. Gusto ko malaman ng bawat isa sa atin ngayon na nakikinig that an open door is actually an opportunity to experience the presence of Christ, okay, sa buhay natin. Not just parang, you know, sa imagination lang natin, but in reality. And that's why God would lead us to such open doors. Now, I want to read this passage that I'm sure siguro narinig nyo na before, but let's look into this passage and expound on it more deeply. Sa Revelation chapter 3, verse 7 to 9, ganito ang sabi, "To the angel of the church in Philadelphia," right. Now, ang context nito, of course, is merong mga letters na sinusulat si Christ bilang recent Lord, you know, doon sa mga churches, doon sa Asia Minor, at isa doon ay Philadelphia. So sabi niya, "These are the words of Him who is holy and true, who holds the key of David." Now, that's Jesus. Okay, si Jesus yung nagsasalita, and basically, He is speaking to the church in Philadelphia para sila ay magkaroon ng awareness sa kalooban ng Panginoon para sa kanila. And then he says this, sabi ni Jesus, "What he opens," referring to himself, "what he opens, no one can shut, and what he shuts, no one can open." Now, you know, if you just read that sa first siguro parang initial reading mo na maybe this is referring sa iba't ibang mga opportunities na binibigay sa atin ng Panginoon. Pero wait lang kayo, it's not talking about that not yet anyway. But what he's talking about dito sa Church of Philadelphia is this. You see, ang background nito is that yung mga churches sa Asia Minor during the first century were going through extreme persecutions. So much so na talagang everything is closing, nagko-close sa lahat ng bagay, including yung kanilang access to the very presence of God through the synagogues. In other words, yung mga mananampalataya are being rejected, no, left and right. Sila, kaya puro closed doors ang mga synagogues, bawal silang pumasok. Parang sinasabi ng mga Hudyo sa kanila, you don't belong here. So here's Jesus addressing yung mga mananampalataya sa Philadelphia. And then he says, what he opens, no one can shut. And what he shuts, no one can open. So kung paano ang mga kalaban nila, mga persecutors nila are closing the doors, sabi ni Jesus, well, I'm opening the door to you. No? And he's of course referring to himself, to his very presence. Now sabi ganyan, I know your deeds. See, I have placed before you an open door that no one can shut. Okay, I know that you have little strength, yet you have kept my word and have not denied my name. In other words, here is a church, sa Philadelphia, who are being persecuted, no, by people around them, mostly Jews. Tapos ayaw silang papasukin doon sa mga synagogues. And you know, yung synagogue is the place of grace para sa mga mananampalataya no first century. And so para saraduhan sila ng ganun, parang ibig sabihin, well, you will not have any access to God. So ang sabi ni Jesus sa kanila to encourage them, huwag kayong mag-alala. Even though sinasarado ng mga tao yung physical na synagogue, as far as the presence of Christ sa buhay nila, they have, you know, instant access. They have the access to the presence of Christ. Kaya ito yung sabi niya sa verse 9. I will make those who are of the synagogue of Satan. That's how he calls yung mga synagogues na yun, no? Who claim to be Jews, though they are not, but are liars, sabi nga yan. I will make them come and fall down at your feet and acknowledge that I have loved you. Wow! You know, sa madaling salita, itong open door na pinag-uusapan natin is really a way for us to experience Christ sa buhay natin. That's why he provides itong mga iba't ibang mga sitwasyon kung saan if we would just trust the Lord, we will experience the presence of Christ sa ating buhay. Now, you know, it's true, ang mga tayo mga mananampalataya, hindi naman tayo mga mayayaman o magagaling, you know, lalo-lalo sa RLCC, you know, hindi naman tayo composed of people who are at the upper level of society. Karamihan sa atin, mga middle class lang. Siguro, with some exceptions, mayroon ilan sa atin na medyo mas nakakaangat sa average. Pero most of us are, you know, middle class or maybe even, you know, lower class. Okay, so sa madaling salita, we are not a strong church, a mega church. We are just a small church. And yet at the same time, if we will just discern and trust God, you know, the Lord will give us open doors kung saan the reality of the presence of Christ can be seen and will be manifested sa buhay natin. Kaya nga napakahalaga na maunawaan natin ito because these are the kinds of opportunities kung saan sasabihin ng Panginoon at i-declare niya that truly He loves us. At lalo-lalo sa sarili natin, it's such an encouragement to know that the Lord truly loves us, di ba? Not just parang theologically, which is true naman talaga, but experientially. Ito rin ang dahilan bakit ko sinasabi sa lahat sa atin to practice spiritual disciplines, to make sure that we arrange our days in such a way na talagang we try to, seek to meet our soul needs through Christ. Kasi doon lang talaga natin mararanasan yung presence ni Christ sa buhay natin. And the Lord would often lead us to situations kung saan if we will trust in the Lord, no, we will see ika nga yung kanyang presence sa buhay natin. So, brothers and sisters, ang open doors gives us access to the presence of Christ. And sino ba naman ang hindi doon, di ba? If you love the Lord, you know, and I know that each one of you are listening right now, you desire to grow in your relationship with Christ. Well, let me tell you, the Lord will give you access sa mga situations and mga, you know, opportunities kung saan yung kanyang love sa atin will become more and more real and experiential. I'm not saying na sa lahat ng pagkakataon, magkakaroon tayo ng ganung klaseng parang consolation. But really, God is so good na pag ikaw ay nadi-discourage, pag may mga nangyayari sa buhay mo, huwag mo lang tingnan yun as parang, wow, ang hirap, difficulty. Tingnan mo yun as an open door. Because when you pray and seek the Lord, God will encourage you and God will help you overcome yung situation na yun. So even yung mga problema can really become open doors. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Pag-uusapan natin later pa yon yung mga iba't ibang klase ng mga ganong opportunities. But for now, let me just reiterate sa inyo yung idea na yung open door is actually an access point to the presence of Christ. Amen? All right. Pangalawa, it gives us access to the purpose of God. Tayo ay maaaring magkaroon ng ikang involvement o bahagi sa nais ng Panginoon ng mangyari. And God is at work in the world. Purihin ng Panginoon. Even siguro, hindi lang natin papansin, pero God is working in the world. Sometimes nakikita lang natin ay yung mga masasama. Pero God is working in the world right now, even as we speak. Now, let's look at Colossians 1:15 to 20. Sabi nga nito ni Apostle Paul, the Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of over all creation. Ibig sabihin, siya yung nasa taas, you know, siya yung nasa, you know, tuktok, diba? For in Him all things were created, things in heaven, no, and on earth, okay, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities. So marami mga, you know, spiritual na mga beings, you know, na hindi natin nakikita. Pero sa lahat ng yan, Jesus is over and above them. So all things have been created through Him and for Him. Alright? Now, siguro sabihin nyo, pati ba yung mga bagay na masasama? Well, sa totoo lang, yung mga powers na yon na naging masama are fallen powers, hindi yun ang original purpose ni Lord para sa kanila. You know, the powers that God has, you know, bestowed upon them, you know, is for is meant to be for the good of God's people. Pero we are living in a fallen world, so merong mga powers and authorities and so forth, na invisible na natin nakikita, who are trying to destroy mankind. Nevertheless, lahat sila ay tinalo na ng ating Panginoong Jesus on the cross. So that's good news para sa atin once maintindihan natin to. Now, sabi sa verse 17, He is before all things, and in Him all things hold together. And He is the head of the body, the church, sabi niya ganyan. He is the beginning and the firstborn from among the dead, so that in everything He might have the supremacy. Now, kailangan maunawaan natin, no? Because yung access natin, you know, sa Panginoon gives us, of course, yung ability to be part of this grand purpose of God kung saan Jesus is Lord over all at tayo ngayon ay under sa Kanya and we are now being sent out into the world with His authority. Now, sabi sa verse 19, For God was pleased to have all His fullness dwell in Him. And through Him to reconcile to Himself all things, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through His blood shed on the cross. In other words, you know, through Christ, God is now fulfilling yung talagang purpose niya o intention niya. So even yung mga powers and authorities, sinabdue niya through Christ, you know, on the cross. At tayo ngayon bilang representatives of God, we are now given the opportunity to be part of this ikaga taking over purpose of the Lord upon the earth. You know, of course, hindi natin gagawin o hindi natin gagamitin ang lakas. But through the gospel, you know, through by sharing the word of God, tayo ay nagiging participants, no, sa pagtupad ng purpose ng Panginoon, which is to redeem the world. Naalala ko, you know, may kwento tukol kay William Booth. Maybe hindi niyo alam ito, but si William Booth, siya yung founder ng Salvation Army, no? And it was sometime in the, middle of 19th century, around this time, July, okay, na si William Booth ay nagkaroon ng passion to preach the gospel at talagang, nag-umpisa siya sa mga kalye-kalye lang, and he just proclaimed the word of God even though nobody was listening to him, at hindi siya nag-give up kahit na pinipersecute siya, because he knew that the Lord was calling him to take part in God's redemptive work. Now, fast forward tayo, to right now where we are. Ang Salvation Army is operating in more than 100 countries around the world. And I wish I can tell you about the other organizations that were put up by people like Bill Bright, yung okay sa navigators, di ba? Maraming mga bagay-bagay na nangyari because the people of God were willing to enter into the open doors that God was giving them, an access to the very purpose of God. No, yung gusto niyang gawin sa mundong ito. Now, I don't feel condemned. You're saying that wala akong nagagawang ganyan mga great things. Well, wherever you are, God can actually use you. Kahit sa kanaroroon, God can use you. He can give you open doors where you work. He can give you open doors kung sa ka naroroon. He can give you open doors sa eskwelahan. The problem is that we are not expecting this, or we are not eager to know kung ano ba yung open doors na binibigay ng Panginoon. Remember, itong mga open doors na to are access points, no? Kung saan we are able to enter into the very presence of Christ and experience the love and presence of Christ sa buhay natin. It's also our access point to the purpose of God. In other words, nagiging bahagi tayo sa redemptive plan ng Panginoon. Now, let me just challenge each of you as you're listening, di ba? Kasi sometimes ang mga mananampalataya, nabobore sila sa Christian life. And so, naghahanap sila ng something interesting, something exciting. So they want to go to that place or do this thing para magkaroon naman ng excitement. Even those who are in ministry, no? Sometimes, minsan, na-burn out sila because, di ba, weekly, nagsuserve sila. You see, because they don't have any vision of this open door na sinasabi ko, no? If you don't have a vision of God's open door for us, for example, itong online ministry natin, if you don't see it as an open door, but simply as a task na kailangan nating gawin, after a while, parang, you just get bored with this, di ba? Tigil na lang natin to, wag na lang natin gawin. No? Or even yung mga ginagawa natin sa iba't ibang lugar like Southridge or Southside. If we don't have a vision for God's open door, these things can just be parang tiresome, no? Parang mabigat na lang sa pandagdag sa mga schedules natin. I know some people, minsan talagang hirap na hirap sila, no, to recruit mga workers or volunteers for ministry. And laging sagot well, busy ako. You know why? Because they don't see yung offer sa kanila as an open door. They're not willing to pray and ask God, Lord, is this an open door for me? Is this where I can experience the presence of Christ? And is this where I can fulfill the purpose of God in my life? You see, this is so important. No, as a church, yung mga bagay na ginagawa natin can be simply seen as something ordinary, or we can see it as an open door. When we see it as an open door, we can experience the presence of Christ when we enter into that door. We can experience the purpose of God when we the purpose of God when we enter into that door. For example, yung open door project natin, di ba? We are praying and trusting God for 7.3 million. Imagine that. Napakalaking halaga. Where are we going to get that money? So there's one way to look at it, and that is, wow, ang taas, di natin kaya yan. O parang ang hirap, di natin kaya. But we can look at it from another way. We can discern and pray, Lord, is this an open door? Kaya nga tawag natin dyan sa, building program natin, Project Open Door. Because we want you to see it as an open door, as an access to the presence of Christ, as an access to the presence, to the purpose rather, of God. So, binibigyan tayo ni Lord ng mga ganito, mga kapatid. If you are bored or burned out or parang wala nangyayari exciting sa buhay mo, don't look elsewhere. Seek the Lord and ask God for open doors. And sometimes those open doors are right before you. Hindi mo lang siya pinapasok because you don't want to see it as a probable or a possible open door. Now, I want to give the third, access point. It gives us access to the power of the Holy Spirit. It gives us access to the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, an open door, is an opportunity, a place para yung presence of Christ ay talaga maranasan natin. It is a access point kung saan the purpose of God can be fulfilled. But siguro ina-expect nyo na sabihin ko to, pero it's really true. Yun din yung paraan at way kung saan we can experience the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, sabi sa Ephesians 5, 15 and 20 to 21. You'll hear maybe this passage again in this series. Pero right now, let me just give you parang an observation dito. Sabi ni Paul, be very careful then how you live. Not as unwise, okay, but as wise. So sa madaling salita, I can live my Christian life bilang unwise person. Nami-miss out ko yung mga open doors, parang sige lang ako, sige sa career ko, sa love life ko, sa pasyal, But I'm not really seeking God's open doors. I can be very unwise, or I can be wise, di ba? Sabi ni Paul, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Actually, literally speaking, yung making the most of every opportunity, sa original Greek is redeeming the time. In other words, buying back the time, In other words, yung oras kasi lumilipas, di ba? So we can actually waste time, and some of you siguro nare-realize yun, tumatanda na kayo, or maybe some of you, para katulad kanina narinig ko si Brother Zep, sabi niya hindi ko nga alam na July na pala, so we can all be in that kind of parang mindset na lumilipas yung time and we're not even mindful about it, di ba? Hindi natin napapansin. Well, sabi ni Paul, huwag tayong ganyan because that is not wise. So, making the most of every opportunity because the days are evil. So, he says, sabi niya in verse 17, paano ba yan? Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Next week, we're going to talk about how to discern open doors. Pero for now, let me tell you, an open door is an invitation for us to experience the presence of Christ, the purpose of God, and the power of the Holy Spirit. Pero that's it. It's an invitation. Pwede mo ma-miss out yun. Pwede hindi mo mapansin. Pwede hindi ka pumasok. Pwede, sige ka lang sige sa buhay mo without really seeing it as an open door. In other words, it can come and pass you by. And others might experience it, pero ikaw hindi. Let me tell you, just be, okay, be open to this. Since open doors ang pinag-uusapan natin, you need to be open. There are many times that God is giving you an opportunity disguised as problems or challenges. Okay? May mga karanasan na dumarating sa buhay mo and they come to you as parang mahirap, it's challenging, di ko kaya, paano ba ito? For example, God is giving you an opportunity to facilitate a small group. So, iniisip mo agad, parang, naku, hirap, may schedule ko, ganyan-ganyan. Instead of discerning whether it is the Lord's will for you to go into that. So, this is the main thing. It's actually an experience that God wants you to enter into, even though, it comes as a disguise. A disguise na parang overwhelming yung problema, parang hindi mo kaya, parang ang daming challenges. But it's actually more important that you discern whether it is the will of God. Now, ako personally, my wife and I, we are going through exactly something like this. We are being offered to go into training for about 16 months. Tapos yung training na yun ay medyo parang, very challenging. Hindi lang doon sa hirap tong course, but also because of the financial cost it would take. And we are in the middle of the building program, di ba? So para sa isip namin, hindi namin kaya ito. Now, thankfully, kinausap kami ng isang good friend who is also the director of the school. Sabi niya, why don't you pray and ask God whether it is the will of God for you? No, so sabi ko, oo nga, no? Kasi, well, malinaw sa amin dalawa ng wife ko that we should be trained as spiritual directors kasi yung course is about spiritual direction. Pero hindi pa namin napag-pray talaga, Lord, is it now? Ngayon ba to? Should we enter into this program right now? So, most of us, kaya ako sinasabi itong illustration na to, most of us say no to open doors without realizing what we are doing. So, we need to understand the Lord's will. Okay? Bago tayo mag-no at bago rin tayo mag-yes kasi meron naman mga tao na para lahat open doors. So that's why I'm going to talk about discernment next week. Kasi may mga tao na anything exciting, ginagrab na agad nila as if it's an open door. It may not be an open door. Okay? Pero definitely, when God gives an open door sa atin, it would be an access to the presence of Christ, the purpose of God, and also the power of the Holy Spirit. That's why sabi ni Paul dito, you know, and I'm just going to touch on this briefly. Sabi niya sa verse 18, do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. So in other words, as an example, yung pag-iinom, alak, no, that leads to debauchery or yung waste of life. Sabi niya, imbis na ganun, okay, instead, sabi niya, be filled with the Spirit, okay, in other words, ito yung naisin mo that you experience the power of the Holy Spirit in your life. And then he begins to unfold this in terms of the following, sabi niya sa verse 19. Speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit. Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord. Always giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Now, in translation, sa NIV, does not reflect yung talagang tunay na sinasabi ni Paul, unfortunately. Pero mayroong ibang mga translations that does that. New American Standard and others. Kaya lang, yung NIV, most of the time, for the sake of readability, no, minsan tinatranslate nila yung mga participles as if they are parang, you know, verbs na normal. But here's the, you know, the right way of reading through that, okay? So yung being filled with the Spirit, sabi niya, be filled with the Spirit, yun ang utos niya. And then 19, speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing and making music from your heart to the Lord. Hindi ibig sabihin na parang kailangan mag-sincere ka, kundi nang gagaling sa integridad ng puso mo. Always giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus and submitting to one another out of reverence for Christ. So as we live our life, you know, in the power of the Spirit, God is going to parang allow us to experience yung working out ng kanyang plan and purpose sa buhay natin to the point that we can really see the fullness of God in our lives. Now, again, you know, let me just tell you, minsan, contento na tayo in just going to the church, okay, attending. Minsan nga, ayaw, may mga tao pa nga, hindi na nga nila pinapahalagaan yung Sunday worship, you know. For example, when I look at the record right now, it's just 56, ano? 56 ang dumadalo. Okay? That may be parang discouraging. Pero sa totoo lang, I'm thinking, okay, why is it that not many people want to participate when the people of God come together? Kasi siguro hindi natin iniisip na this is an open door. When we worship, when we sing praises to God, when we go to the Lord with gratitude in our hearts, when we relate with one another, yung ibig sabihin ng submitting to one another, when we relate with one another in love, in community, mga kapatid, God is giving us an open door to the very power of the Holy Spirit working in our lives. Misa, di lang talaga kasi natin nakikita ng gano'n kasi we are focused more sa sarili natin. Halimbawa, sabihin natin, well, hindi ko feel yung online eh. Well, if you focus on yourself, ganun nga talaga magiging attitude mo. And, siyempre, you would not, you know, waste time being in a Sunday worship online like this. Pero if you see the Sunday worship at katulad din ng iba pang places of grace, whether online yan, like daily devotions or whatever, including yung mga face-to-face gathering, lahat yan mga places of grace. Eh. In other words, these are open doors for us to experience the power of the Holy Spirit in our lives. When we are giving thanks to God, when we are drawing near to God, when we are submitting ourselves to one another, when we are relating in love in community, mga kapatid, these are open doors. Kaya nga yung bawat ano natin, pagtitipon natin, whether online or in person or face to face, is actually an opportunity to experience the power of the Holy Spirit. Now think about that. A lot of us are missing out on these opportunities because hindi natin tinitingnan to bilang an open door. Even those who attend minsan, either face-to-face o ano, pag wala tayong expectation it's an open door, it can just be a regular meeting, di ba? And then we would always parang look for something else to do. Halika, pasyal tayo, halika, labas tayo. Because we are looking at those things as opportunities para sumaya tayo, but we don't look at the open doors that God is providing for us to experience the presence of Christ, the purpose of God, and the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, this is just an introduction. Pero what I'm going to say to you right now should be something na talagang kailangan yung pag-isipan maigi. Open door is our foretaste of heaven on earth. You know, an open door is our foretaste. In other words, pinapa-experience natin ng Panginoon. What we would be experiencing in the new heavens and the new earth, you know, in a grand scale. Pero patikim ngayon, pinapatikim sa atin ng Panginoon. So, mayroong mga bagay that comes into our lives disguised as a problem or a challenge, but actually it's an open door. Mayroong mga situations that comes into our life, mga ministry opportunities na mukhang mahirap, pero actually it's an open door. So all we really have to do right now is learn how to discern that. But we're going to talk about that next week. For now, today, gusto ko maintindihan nyo. Open door, or any open door coming from God, is our foretaste of heaven on earth. So, here's what I'm going to tell you right now. We must not miss this opportunity. No, dito sa buong series na to, and starting next Sunday, magkakaroon tayo ng prayer gathering. I want you to really open your heart to the possibility, no, of God, you know, giving you these open doors, kung saan you can have access to the presence of Christ, the purpose of God, and the power of the Holy Spirit. Don't miss out on this opportunity. Amen? So again, ulitin ko po, start praying this week for open doors. In fact, sumama kayo sa prayer gathering next Sunday at 11 a.m. doon po sa Real Life Center. I-zoom din natin yan. Gagamit din tayong Zoom for those who cannot come physically. But let me tell you, let's get excited sa Christian life. You don't have to go very far para magkaroon ng saysay yung buhay mo. Maybe you're bored, so iniisip mo kung siguro maglalakbay ako dito, baka sumaya ako. Or kung if I can have this relationship, siguro nililigaya ako. No, these things are just artificial. They don't last. Diba? For those of you who have experienced things in this world na parang sa umpisa masaya, you know what I mean. After a while, wala na yon. So, parang addict. So, you're going to look for something else para mapunuan na naman ulit yung need of your soul. But let me tell you, God has open doors. At yung open doors na yan, yan ang magbibigay sa iyo ng foretaste, no, of heaven on earth. If you are listening right now, and you are the kind of person na parang, yes, totoo yun, pastor, parang nabubor nga ako sa Christian life ko eh. O parang walang nangyayari. I'm always looking for things to you know, para magkaroon ng excitement yung buhay ko. Well, you are just like many others. And my exhortation to you this morning dito sa series natin is, look into this idea of open doors. Kasi dito mo mararanasan ang presence of Christ, ang purpose of God, and the power of the Holy Spirit. Of course, you have to discern it. At hindi lahat ng bagay na magaganda is an open door. In fact, sometimes, ang mga dumarating sa buhay natin na hindi maganda is actually God's open door. So we need to discern. But right now, let me encourage you. Ang Christian life is not meant to be boring. It is not meant to be parang a tedious day by day na parang you're just trying to obey the rules. Hindi po. The Christian life is an exciting life. Because it is a life characterized by the presence of Christ, the purpose of God, and the power of the Holy Spirit. So as the Lord leads you and guides you, I pray na matututo tayo mag-desire at mag-discern ng open doors. If you know somebody right now na parang ang Christian life nila is parang coasting along, no? Naka-autopilot, walang nangyari, anything that is truly sabihin natin parang fulfilling and glorifying to God. Pray for them and also share this sermon with them. So right now, let's pray. Lord, salamat po for showing us and revealing to us na meron palang open doors na galing sa iyo, Panginoon. And sometimes they may not come as an exciting thing at first. It may come as a challenge or disguised as a problem. Disguised as something na parang hindi namin kaya. But Lord, you are the God of open doors. And you want us to have a foretaste of heaven right here on earth. Would you help us, Panginoon? Would you help us, O Lord God, to desire and to discern itong mga open doors na ito? This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.